Today I will talk about how paleodietary investigation could help in the reconstruction of sociocultural aspects of prehistoric human groups, with some cases from Italian Copper Age. So the Copper Age, as we saw this morning also, is a phase where we see the continuation of the significant impact on the environment which started in the Neolithic period, and the development of metallurgy, as we listened this morning, favored new network of exchange and land use. The archaeological evidence, mostly from material culture, suggests intense relation between groups all over the peninsula. However, most of the archaeological data comes from funerary context, so maybe we have a limited picture of social and cultural practices. The funerary ritual is complex, with some recurring aspects in various regions of the peninsula, although with local features and variations. And the sharing of ritual aspects seems to suggest that the interaction on the territory did not concern only material objects. In central and southern Italy, single and collective burials in artificial and natural caves are attested, as we saw also this morning, in most cases featuring secondary deposition. The tombs are clustered in necropolises that show prolonged use. This cultural expression could let us think that such necropolises were landmarks on the territory for individuals that may be wishes for individuals wishes to share over time the same resting place. However, this assumption derives from ritual contexts which could skew our understanding of socioeconomic aspects. So we selected the dietary practices as a possible direct evidence of the effective bond with the territory and any social differentiations. In this perspective, we decided to directly analyze the more readily available resource for this period, the skeletal remains. But where do the food choices come from? Of course, they depend on resource availability, but as still happens today, we could think that the ideological precept shared by community, a cultural group, and also the tradition with which we grew up had a fundamental influence on food choices and practices. Just think about certain food taboo linked to religion or culinary tradition of each region and country, which in any case seem to be based on the influence of the environment in which they were developed. Considering the archaeological background described earlier, we attempted to investigate how much the food practices can present features shared on a large scale, as well as the funeral ritual and material culture seem to have had, or rather, reflect specific cultural identities linked to the local history of each group. Here, we attempted to analyze the relationship of stable isotopes beyond the mere subsistence reconstruction. So this is one of the aims of my PhD project on central and southern Italy, through the isotopic analysis on different proxies. We will present here only some preliminary results from six sites from three of the most representative cultures of the Italian Copper Age. And I will show some characteristics. The Rinaldone group has its diffusion in central Italy, with a spread up to the Adriatic coast, although with some ritual variations. And the necropolis seems really close to each other. The three presented here are 3 to 10 kilometers apart, with a long time span used, reflected in the several radiocarbon datings available for this culture. On the other hand, Gaudio and La Terza context have limited availability of radiocarbon dates, and they are a little bit later, as you could see, yes, from the air, and seem more limited in time and space. Both are diffused more in the south, talk with evidence up to Rome. The necropolises of La Terza and Gaudio culture seem more homogeneously diffused over the territory with more extensive occupation, like the two sampled here from Gaudo culture that are 30 kilometers apart. Some differences are also expressed in the funerary ritual. For example, the sites of Rinaldone culture here presented show mostly primary deposition accompanied by sporadic secondary burials, normally poorly represented in the tombs. Also, the number of tombs in each necropolis is pretty high, as we can see, while Gaudo and La Terza culture show more numerous depositions for each tomb, with one or two primary burials, mostly of men, per tomb. Like here in Eboli e Buccino, there are depositions from 8 to 30 individuals per tomb. And here are presented the individuals that I analyzed on the all individuals from the necropolis, and the tomb that I analyzed from all the over the number of the total tomb per necropolis. So you can see there is a selection of this necropolis. So the results that I will show you, they should be taken into account as not fully representative of the culture or neither of the necropolises. So the primary results from the site of Rinaldone culture, see that are three sites, Ponte San Pietro, La Porcareccia e Chiusa d'Ermini, seems to reflect the topographic clustering of the necropolis on the territory that I showed you before. There is a strong homogeneity between the protein food intake at the three sites, apparently unchanged over time, considering the long time span than more than a millennium. These results show a mixed terrestrial diet, but comparison with faunal data available from Tyrrhenian area, since that animal protein is not so substantial in the diet, considering the carbon and hydrogen enrichment. Contemporary data from Grosseto area, that is a little further northern, show greater heterogeneity. They are this blue one. Show greater heterogeneity and greater consumption of an animal protein intake also. In our sample, the protein intake do not seem to reflect differences according to gender or age, neither in relation to the qualitative and quantitative richness of the grave goods. So if there were social differences within the group, they don't seem to be reflected in the diet. By lighting the tomb of origin within each site, this little zoom, it is trying to observe small clusters of individuals corresponding to the same tomb, although this is not necessarily isotopic significant, as we can see. It is clearly linked to differences in food practices or access to food resources between the different tombs. If you consider that each tomb is used across a long period of time, this becomes even more remarkable and might reflect the prolonged expression of food practices among maybe possible kin-related groups. Also, in the two necropolises of the Gaudo culture, that are Buccino and Eboli, in the province of Salerno, the protein intake do not seem to reflect any social differentiation, as suggested by the differences in the grave good composition. Some gender diversification in the protein intake seems to emerge in the Eboli group. The female individual never exceeds a certain nitrogen value, but this is not statistically significant. So, regarding the tomb of provenance of the sample, unsurprising, the tomb 7 of Buccino and tomb 4 of Eboli, that are the most numerous tombs of each necropolis, respectively 25 and 35 individuals per tomb, show a greater dispersion, the gray one in both graph, a greater dispersion or food variability than the individual of other contexts. This might be linked either to sample size or to time of use of the burial. A faunal assemblage more directly associable with this necropolis is about to be analyzed. So here they are compared with the fauna from central Italy, and the animal protein intake seems more significant in the overall diet of these two necropolises. which, by the way, show almost superimposed values. From the eponymous necropolis of La Terza, we sampled only individual coming from tomb 3, so they are only from the same tomb, these individual, the blue one. There is a larger variability of isotopic values both in the carbon and hydrogen data, which could be associated to a likely long occupation that is, there is a steam of about 500 years. Here there is a statistically significant difference between the nitrogen values of male and female of about 1 per mil, and the comparison with the faunal data coming from the surrounding indicate a limited consumption of animal proteins, the yellow one. There are comparable data from the same geographic area, from a little natural cave, namely Grottanisco, with a more limited occupation in time, which shows too a pretty large variability in the nitrogen values, but a greater animal protein intake. So the three groups of samples come from different geographic locations, so that could have influenced locally the carbon and nitrogen values. However, it is interesting to notice the wider range of the Gaudon La Terza groups as opposed to the Rinaldone one. Even more remarkable if we consider that both Gaudon La Terza contexts have a limited time of occupation comparing to the Rinaldone samples. At La Terza, there is a wider variability also in the carbon values, for which we could assume maybe a marine contribution to the diet. It is interesting to notice that two composite fishing hooks were found in two hypogea of the necropolis, one of them being precisely the tomb 3 presented here. So, to conclude and putting our isotopic data in relation to the archaeological background, if you think about the archaeological data in the Gaudon La Terza group, which seemed to have a wider access to the practice of burial, needed the limited period of use and a larger number of depositions, we might get the picture of individuals practicing perhaps more diversified economic activities, which led them to move and exploit different environments, also for the research of raw materials over a wider area. In brief, it is possible that the Gaudon La Terza people had to exploit a wider environment to obtain the same set of resources that the Rinaldone ones would have obtained through the exploitation of a relatively limited territory. In fact, the topography of the cemeteries and the homogeneity of the isotopic data for the Rinaldone group could refer to practices for which there was no need to look for the resources elsewhere or to recur to change them over time, possible by virtue of the wide range of available resources in that area. This preliminary observation will be documented with the increase of the number of the site and associable archaeobotanical and faunal samples that are about to be analyzed. So, it is interesting to see how the set of isotopic signatures seem to reflect the use of the territory with a pattern that followed the topographic distribution deduced from the dispersion or grouping of the necropolis in each area. Therefore, to answer our initial question, we could say that the local cultural tradition appeared to be reflected in differences in food practices, which seem to be strictly linked to the territory and to confirming that kind of attachment suggested by the funerary data, maybe. On the other hand, any differences in status assumed by the funerary data appear not to be reflected in a different access to resources, to the food resource. Thank you.